कंप्यूटर हिस्ट्री पार्ट 5.1 जनरेशन ऑफ अ कंप्यूटर। हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन व्हाट आर ऑल द मेन कंपोनेंट्स फीचर्स आर यूज्ड इन फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर्स एंड द सेकेंड जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स। सो लेट अस लर्न वन बाय वन इन डिटेल्स। फर्स्ट जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स एग्जिस्ट इन 1942 टू 1955। In first generation computers, we used vacuum tubes for central processing unit. And this vacuum tube was developed by Lee DeForest. And we used magnetic drum for storage. And look at the figure. You can see the picture of vacuum tubes. So in this picture, the vacuum tubes is exactly looks like an electric bulb, isn't it? It is made of glass. So we have to handle it very carefully. You know that when an electric bulb burns for a longer time, it produces a heat. Likewise, if we are using a lot of vacuum tubes, it will also produce a lot of heat and prone to frequent fusing or damaging of the installation. Therefore, they were used very expensive and could be afforded only by very large organization. Look at the figure. This is the picture of punch card. So in first generation computers, we used punched card and paper tape as an input device. So now we are using the keyboards, but in first generation computers we use the punch cards. And punch card is a thick as a mattress, and the punch card contains a lots of holes and all the data is stored inside these holes. And this data is read using a machine called punch card reader. And the output was displayed on paper, or we can say that the output was displayed on printouts. And in the previous class, we already learned about the different languages. So in the first generation computers, it used machine language. To explain what are all the advantages of this first generation computers. So, first one, these computers were the fastest calculating device of their time. They could perform computations in milliseconds. The vacuum tube technology made possible to the arrival of this electronic digital computers. But it had a few disadvantages also. So let us look at the disadvantages. As I told you, it used a lots of vacuum tubes and a single vacuum tube size is large. So that time the computer was too bulky in size, and also I told you it produces a lots of heat. It required air conditioning to control the temperature. And due to this excess of heat emission, it prone to frequent hardware failure. And also its input and output operations are very slow. So these are all the things that we talked about the first generation of the computers. Now let us look the important points. So as I told you, the first generation computers exist between 1942 to 1955, and the main component used in this first generation is vacuum tubes, and it works in and its working speed is milliseconds, and the input device used here is punch cards, paper tape, magnetic tape, and the secondary devices used is magnetic drum for storage. Okay. And the language used in this generation is machine language. And first generation, and the examples of the first generation of the computers are ENIAC, EDVAC, EDSAC, and IBM 650. Now let us talk about the second generation computers. Second generation computers starts from 1955 to 1964. So in the second generation computers, we used transistors instead of vacuum tubes. And these transistors are invented after first generation of computers, and invention of transistor by a team led by William Shockley. In comparison to computers of the first generation, the computing time taken by the computers of the second generation was lesser. Also, the transistors that we used is very cheaper and it consumes less power and more compact in size and more reliable and faster than this vacuum tubes. Let's see what are all the advantages of second generation computers. The second generation computers are smaller in size as compared to first generation computers, and also it is more reliable and it generates less heat and less prone to hardware failure, and it is wider commercial used. And the disadvantages of the second generation computers are still it produces a lots of heat and we required an air conditioning. Let's see the useful points of second generation computers. So second generation computers starts in the year 1955 to 1964, and the main components used in second generation computer are transistors, and its working speed is in microseconds. The input output device used here is paper tapes, magnetic tape, visual display unit, and the secondary storages are paper tape, magnetic drum, magnetic disc, etc. And the language used here is assembly language and some high level languages like Fortran, COBOL, etc. Examples of second generation computers are IBM 1401, IBM 7090, IBM 1620, IBM 7094, IBM 700 series, CDC 1604, CDC 3600, UNIVAC 1108T. Now let us write this in your notebook. Questions and answers. What are all the components used in first generation computers? Vacuum tubes. Second question, write an example of first generation computers. Examples are ENIAC, EDVAC, EDSAC. Question number 3. What are the components used in second generation of computers? Transistors. Question number 4. Write an example of second generation computers. IBM 1401. Now write these useful points in your notebook. Thank you, children.